Very good morning, students. Today is the third lecture in module one for the course Analog Electronics. And in today's lecture, the focus would be on the structure of the transistor. Okay, or to be more precise, the learning objective for the session three of module one would be you will get an understanding on the structure of the transistor. You will also have an understanding of the current flow in the active mode, okay, as we have discussed the three different operating modes of the transistor. And more specifically, we know that for the amplification application, the active mode is of prime importance. And so we will see the what is the current flow in the active mode, or when the transistor in the active mode of operation. We will also see the diffusion current, that is the movement of the electrons or the holes in case of the NPN transistor. And so we will focus the discussion on diffusion current to the base. And then we will also get a deep understanding on the transistor characteristics. And what is the influence of temperature on the transistor and its characteristics. So when we say transistor kind of characteristics, we are trying to see what is the relationship between or how the voltage and the current behave with respect to each other. And also we will introduce you to the early effect of the transistor, okay, which is also called as the base width modulation. Okay, so let's see first what is the structure of or how does the transistor structure looks like in real scenario. Okay, so if you see observe in the slide here, you see the structure here, and this is for a NPN configuration. You can see the three terminals, the emitter, the base, and the collector terminal here. Okay, and you see the emitter is N, or it is the made up of it is surrounded by the N region. The base is surrounded by the P region, and the collector is surrounded by the N region. So we are focusing the discussion or the structure that is shown here is for a NPN configuration, or for an NPN transistor, okay, BJT transistor. And if you observe the structure, you can notice that the collector is virtually surrounded by the emitter region. So thus making it difficult for the electrons to be injected into the thin base to escape being collected. Okay. So in this way, the resulting gain, okay, we call it as the collector current gain, the alpha is very close to unity, and we have another component that is the beta, okay, which is again, okay, ratio of IC by IB, right, which is very large, okay. And if we observe, the device is not symmetrical, okay, that is, there is no uniform distribution of the region, or region wise they are not uniformly distributed, right. So if you observe, the emitter and the collector cannot be interchanged, and the structure also indicates that the common or the collector base junction has a much larger area than the emitter base. Okay, so if you see, the collector base junction has a larger area than the emitter base junction, and this has an influence on the current component, right. So the collector base diode, okay, so a transistor is nothing but the three terminal device, or a three layer device, right. So the diode, that is, it is very similar to a scenario where two PN junctions or NPN, okay. So the NPN is you are trying to connect two diodes back to back, right. So the collect collector base diode, that is collector base diode is represented by, if you represent that by DC, has a saturation current, and we represent saturation current as ISC, right? And thus it is much larger than the saturation current of the emitter base diode. If you look at the transistor as two diodes, okay, so if I have to conceptualize in terms of a diode operation, then DC will the collector the saturation current due to the collector base transistor diode has a much the saturation current is much larger compared to the emitter base a diode or a DE. Okay, and typically the saturation current due to the collector base is roughly 10 to 100 times larger than the saturation current due to the emitter base junction. Okay, so that is if we recall the relation between ISC, okay, that is the saturation current for the emitter. ISC is nothing but IS divided by alpha, okay, and which is almost proportional to IS because it is alpha is equal to 1, okay. So if the emitter and the collector are reversed, that is say if the collector base junction is forward biased and the emitter base junction is reverse biased, the device operates in the mode called as the reverse active mode, okay, and the resulting value of alpha and beta represented as alpha R and beta R, okay, which implies that it is the reverse gain, okay, and they are much smaller, or they are much less than lower than alpha beta for in the active mode, okay, when the transistor is forward biased, okay. So if I have to explain the operation of the BJT, okay, or for an NPN transistor, the transistor is considered to operate in active or the normal mode of operation. The emitter base junction should be forward biased and the collector base junction should be reverse biased. So this situation, if we observe the energy band diagram, okay, the forward bias of the emitter base junction lowers the emitter base potential, okay, potential barrier, whereas the reverse bias of the collector base junction increases the collector base potential barrier. So under forward bias, lowering of the potential barrier at the emitter junction results in the injection of the electrons into the base and the holes into the emitter. Okay, so the injunction injected holes, that is the injunction of holes from the base to the emitter constitutes the emitter hole current, and the injected electrons, which are the minority carriers in the base, right? Because the base is the P region where holes are the majority carriers, right? So the injected electrons, which are the minority carriers in the base, diffuse across the base layer, okay, they diffuse across the base layer, giving rise to, okay, they diffuse across the base layer, giving rise to a current which is ISE, that is this emitter current, okay, and it is highly desirable to have an IE much greater than INE. That is N because of implying N region, okay? And P, when I say IPE, it implies the P region, electrons flowing from the P region, okay? It is highly desirable for to have an INE much greater than IPE. And this can be accomplished by fabricating the device with a heavily doped emitter and a lightly doped base. And thus the BJT is designed to have a high density of electrons in the emitter and a low density of holes in the base. So some injected electrons recombine with the holes in the base, and but majority of the injected electrons survive the recombination and reaches the collector region. So in order to reduce the injected minority carriers carrier loss by recombination, the base region is made up of a thinner and a lightly doped. I mean, it is lightly doped. Okay, and the reverse bias at the base collector junction will establish a strong drift field for the minority carriers at the base. Thus, the electrons which reach the collector region are instantaneously swept out. That is due to the fall down of the barrier potential. Or the potential barrier, or collected by a strong field at the depletion layer of the collector base junction. Consequently, a large current may flow in the reverse biased junction, that is INC, resulting from a carrier injunction of the nearby, that is the emitter junction. Thus, this is the basis for the transistor action and is realized only when the two junctions are physically close enough to interact in a manner as desired. The difference between the INE and INC represents the holes that are supplied by the base to recombine with the electrons in the base layer. Okay, so if I observe or if I have to talk about the current flow, okay, so if I have to talk about the current flow in the NPN transistor based to operate in the active mode, that is the reverse component due to the drift, thermally generated minority carriers are not shown here, okay. So the forward bias of the emitter base junction will cause the current flow across the junction, and the current will consist of two components. One is the electrons injected from the emitter into the base, and the holes injected into the base, holes injected by the base into the emitter, or from the base into the emitter. So it is highly desirable to have the electrons from the emitter to the base, and at a much higher level than the second, that is the holes from the base to the emitter. And this can be accomplished, as I said, by fabricating the device with a highly doped emitter and a lightly doped base. Okay, and the device is designed to have a high density of electrons in the emitter and low density of holes in the base. Okay, so the current that flows across the emitter base junction will constitute the emitter current, okay, IE, and the direction of IE is out of the emitter lead or the emitter terminal, okay, following the usual convention, as is the direction of the positive charge flow, the whole current, and opposite to the direction of the negative charge flow, that is the electron current. Since the electron components is much larger than the hole components, the emitter current will be dominated by the electron components. Let us now, if we have to consider the electrons injected from the emitter to the base, the electrons will be the minority carriers in the p-type base. And because of the base is usually very thin, in a steady state, the excess minority carriers, okay, that is the electron concentration in the base is or will have almost a straight line profile. Okay, it will have almost a straight line profile as seen here, as shown in the diagram here, and it indicates the line indicated in the solid line. Okay, solid straight line. So the electron concentration will be highest. And it is denoted by NP, okay, it is denoted by NP at the emitter side and lowest at the collector side, okay, and highest at the emitter side and lowest at the collector side, okay. As in the case of for any forward biased PN junction, the concentration will be proportional to, we know that it is proportional to e to the power VBE divided by VT, right? So this minority carrier distribution in the base results from the boundary condition imposed by the two junctions, okay? So it is not an exponential decaying curve or a decay distribution, which would result if the base region were infinitely thick. Okay, and here the base region is thin and it causes the distribution to decay linearly. Okay, and further the reverse bias on the collector base junction causes the electron concentration at the collector side of the base to be a zero. Okay, and we also know that NP is equal to, I mean, NP of 0 is equal to, okay, NP of 0, that is the diffusion of electrons to the base, is set by a concentration profile at the electron base junction, where NP of 0 is equal to NP naught e power VBE by VT, okay, where NP naught is the thermal equilibrium value of the minority carrier, that is the for the base, the minority carrier is the electrons and electron concentration in the base region, and VBE is the forward base emitter bias voltage, and VT is the thermal voltage, which is equal to approximately 25 millivolt at the room temperature. So the reason for the zero concentration at the collector side of the base is that the positive collector voltage VCB causes the electrons at the end to be swept across the collector base junction depletion region. Okay, so you see that the tapered minority here, okay, so you see the tapered minority carrier combination, okay, or the minority carrier concentration profile causes the electrons injected into the base to diffuse through the base region towards the collector, and this electron diffusion current is directly proportional to, okay, which is denoted as IN, okay, so this is directly proportional to AE Q dN dNP of x by dx, where AE is the cross-sectional area of the base emitter junction, okay, and so it is in direction perpendicular to the, okay, it is perpendicular to, okay, and Q is nothing but the magnitude of the electron charge, and dN is the electron diffusion diffusivity, okay, in the base, or diffusion in the base, and W represents the width, okay, so W basically represents the effective width of the base, and if we observe the negative slope, okay, if you observe the negative slope of the minority carrier concentration, results in a negative current IN across the base, and this IN flows from right to the left, okay, right to left, and which corresponds to usual convention, namely opposite to the direction of the electron flow. So some of the electrons that are diffusing through the base region will combine with holes, which are the majority carriers in the base. However, since the base is usually very thin and lightly doped, the proportion of electrons lost through the recombination process will be very small. Okay. And the recombination in the base region causes the excessive minority carrier concentration profile to deviate from the straight line, taking a slightly concave shape. Okay. See the one indicated in the dotted line, okay, or a broken line. So the slope of the concentration profile at the emitter base junction is slightly higher than the collector base junction. Okay, it is slightly higher than the collector base junction, with the difference accounting for a small number of electrons lost in the base region due to recombination. Okay. So this is about the diffusion current through the base. Okay, now we'll see what is the collector current and or what is the value of the collector current and the base current. Okay, so coming to the collector current, as you see, most of the diffusing electrons will reach the boundary of the collector base depletion region. Because the collector current is more positive, okay, or because the collector is more positive than the base, okay, by VCB, I mean what you are representing as VCB volts, okay, the successful, electrons will be swept across the collector base junction depletion region into the collector, and they will thus get collected to constitute the collector current IC. And so IC is equal to IN, which will yield a negative value for IC, indicating that IC flows in the negative direction of the axis. And since we will take this to be the positive direction, we can drop the negative sign. And so during, so you can express the collector current as IC is equal to IS into EVBE by VT, okay, where IS is, okay, so here if you see IC is equal to IS EVB by ET, VT, where saturation current, where IS is the saturation current, IS is equal to QAE DN NP by W, and we can rewrite the saturation current as QAE DN NI square by NAW, okay. So substituting for NP of naught by NI, so we are substituting, replacing NPO by NI square by NA, okay, where NI is the intrinsic carrier density and NA represents the doping concentration of in the base, okay. And so your IS can be expressed as QAE DN NI square divided by NAW. Okay. One more important observation to be made here is the magnitude of IC is independent of, okay. So if you see, it is independent of the potential across the collector base. Okay. Or it is independent of VCB. Okay. That is, as long as the collector is positive with respect to the base, the electrons that reach the collector side of the base region will be swept into the collector and the will be swept across the collector, and it will be collected as the collector current, or it is denoted as the collector current. So the saturation current is inversely proportional to the base with W, and it is also directly proportional to the area of the emitter base junction. So typically IS is range of say 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power minus, I'm sorry, 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 18 amps, depending on the size of the device. And because IS is proportional to NI square, it is where NI represents your intrinsic carrier density, okay. So it is a strong function of the temperature. Approximately it doubles for every 5 degree raise in temperature, okay, because of the dependency of NI square on temperature, Okay, and since IS is directly proportional to the junction area, it will also be referred to as the scale current. And two transistors that are identically except, so if we consider two transistors that are identically the same, and one has an electron based junction area twice the other, okay, it will have a saturation current with the same ratio, thus the same value VB, the larger device will have a collector current twice that of the smaller device. Okay, so this concept is frequently employed in the integrated circuit designs. Okay, and if we have to notice, okay, if you observe the characteristics of the collector emitter, if we observe the VI characteristics or IC versus VCE characteristics, in common emitter configuration, the collector base junction. Okay, so here if you observe in the first diagram for varying IB value, okay, for varying IB value, we see the collector current versus the voltage across the VCE. Okay, so in and the second diagram is to show the common emitter avalanche breakdown voltage. Okay, so in so if we observe the collector current behavior, okay, we are considering the configuration of the transistor to be in the common emitter configuration. Okay, we are considering the common emitter configuration, and if we observe the output characteristics of the common emitter in this configuration, the characteristics here shows that the collector current and the collector voltage, okay, the collector emitter voltage, okay, or the collector voltage for various fixed values of IB, and this characteristics is often called as the collector characteristics, and this is for the common emitter configuration. So if you observe the value of beta of the transistor can be found at any point on the characteristics by taking the ratio of ratio of IC to IB at the point of beta is equal to IC divided by IB, and this is known as so if it is beta DC, then it is the DC beta of the for the transistor. So for the output characteristics, we can also see the change in the collector emitter voltage, which causes the causes a little change in the collector current for a constant base current, and thus the output dynamic resistance is high in common emitter configuration. Okay, where output resistance is nothing but delta VCE by delta IC. Okay, keeping the base current a constant, okay, or IB constant, or delta IB a constant. So the output characteristics of a common emitter configuration consist of, as you know, it consists of the three regions: the active region, okay, which is represented by the flat area of response, and then you have the saturation region, which is increasing exponentially, and then you have the cutoff region. Okay, here you have the cutoff region. Okay, so in for the operation in active region, the emitter base junction in the is to be forward biased, and the collector base junction is to be reverse biased, and the collector current raised more sharply with increasing VCE in the linear region of the output characteristics of the collector emitter transistor. Okay, and in case of the saturation region, okay, the green region shown here, okay, in this region, the emitter base junction and the collector base junction both are forward biased, and the saturation value of VCE, designated as VCE sat, okay, VCE sat, usually range anywhere between 0.1 to 0.3 volts. Okay, and in the cutoff region, that is below IB equal to 0. Okay, that is the cutoff region. IB is equal to 0. In this region, both the junction of the transistors are reverse biased. And to identify the operating region of the transistor, we can observe certain condition, that is for saturation, your IB should be greater than IC by beta DC. For cutoff, IB should be equal to 0. And for active region, VCE should be greater than VCE sat. Okay, so this talks about the collector, about the output characteristics in the common common emitter configuration. Okay, and if the second graph basically shows the common emitter avalanche breakdown. So in common emitter configuration, avalanche breakdown occurs when the common emitter current amplification factor, that is beta, is infinite. Okay, so when the voltage across the collector and the emitter terminal is high, the carrier diffuse into the base from the collector. So as a result of this, the base emitter diode of the transistor is forward biased, causing the transistor to turn on. When the collector base voltage, that is VCB, reaches VA, which is called as the avalanche voltage or the breakdown voltage, VBR here. Okay, in this case, the number of carrier generated by the avalanche multiplication equals the number of carriers that are injected at the emitter injunction efficiency and transported to the depletion region at the base transport factor, and this causes the collector current to continue flowing without the need for the base current supply. And as the collector voltage lowers, it's lower than the breakdown voltage, the base current IB flows in the forward direction, causing beta to be a positive. So at the collector voltage higher than the breakdown voltage, the base current IB flows in the reverse direction, causing beta to be negative. Okay, and that again, this also depends. So when the input base current is constant, the collector current of the transistor in the common emitter configuration can also be calculated as IC is equal to beta times IB plus 1 plus beta ICBO. Okay, where beta represents your common emitter current amplification factor. Okay, so the temperature dependency of the breakdown voltage is determined by the temperature dependency of VB, again alpha, and also the ICBO or ICEO. In this case, the temperature coefficient can be positive or it can be negative. Okay. And again, when the base terminal is connected to the emitter terminal through the resistor, the collector current reverses. Okay. So if we have to represent or observe the base current. So the base current basically consists of two components. The first component is IB1 due to the holes injected from the base region into the emitter region. And this current component is proportional to EVE e to the power VBE by VT. Okay. And the second component is the second component of the base current is IB2, and this is due to the holes that have to be supplied by the external circuit in order to replace the holes lost from the base through the recombination process. Okay, and so because IB2 is proportional to the number of electrons injected into the base, and this will also be equal to e to the power VBE by VT. Thus, the total base current will be the sum of IB1 and IB2. Okay, and it is proportional to e to the power, which is proportional to e to the power VBE by VT. And it can be expressed as a fraction of the collector current. Okay, that is, IB is also related to beta and IC, as IB is equal to IC divided by beta, right? And so the holes injected from the base region into the emitter region is given by IB1, which is QAE dP ni square ND LP e to the power VBE by VT. And holes supplied due to the recombination of the base with the diffusing electrons and depending on the minority carrier life, the base current IB2 is equal to QAEW Ni square divided by Na e to the power VBE plus by VT. Okay, so the total base current is equal to IB1 plus IB2. Okay, and so IB is equal to, can also be expressed as IS into VB e to the power VBE divided by VT divided by beta, where beta is your transistor parameter. So for a NPN transistor, beta can be in the range of 50 to 200, but it can be as high as 1000 for the special devices, and for reasons that it will become, the parameter beta is called as the, and for this reason, the parameter beta is called as the common emitter current gain. Again, beta is again highly influenced by two factors. The one is the width of the, so if you observe, it can be influenced by the width, okay, by the width of the base region W, and relatively also by the doping of the base region, okay, base region and the emitter region, okay, Na by Nd. So to obtain a high beta, which is highly desirable, since beta represents a gain parameter, the base should be very thin. Okay, that is W should have a very small value, and it should be lightly doped, and the consumer and the emitter should be heavily doped. Okay, which will in turn reduce Na by Nd. Okay, or which will yield in very small Na by Nd. So for modern integrated circuits fabrication technology, W is in the nanometer ranges. Okay, so this is about the base current, and now let's see the current voltage characteristics of current voltage characteristics for the transistor. So here you can see the we have seen the physical structure of the transistor, and we have also seen the current the collector current and the base current, we have also discussed on the current flow, right? So here we see two different both the NPN and the PNP configurations, and which is based, and again we will also try to discuss on the how it operates. Both NPN and PNP operates in the active mode, so it should so the arrangement is shown, and we also see that the difference in the transistor for an NPN and a PNP is the direction of your emitter arrow, right? And so if we have to this also represents the practical biasing scheme for an NPN and a PNP transistor, okay? And it represents the reference and actual direction of the current flow throughout the transistor, for the convenience of the circuit drawing, network is shown, like, or the connection is shown in the slide here, the arrowhead on the emitter implies the polarity of the emitter base voltage and should be applied in order to forward bias the emitter base junction. Just a glance at the circuit symbol of the PNP transistor, for example, indicate that we should make the emitter higher in potential or voltage than the base, in order to cause the current flow into the emitter region, okay, that is downwards. And note that the symbol VEB means, VEB means that the voltage by which the emitter is higher than the base. And similarly for and in case of the okay, so for NPN it is VBE, and for PNP it is VEB. Okay, so for a PNP transistor operating in active mode, VEB is positive, while for a NPN transistor, VBE is also positive. Okay, and it also follows that the NPN transistor is connected to a DC source as so as to operate in the active mode, and the electron base junction, okay, is forward biased, and it will operate in the active mode as long as the collector voltage does not fall below it does not fall below 0.7 volts, okay, or it does not fall below that of the base by more than approximately 0.4 volts. Otherwise, the transistor will leave the active mode and enter into the saturation mode of operation. Okay, similarly for the PNP transistor, will operate in the active mode of the emitter base junction forward biased, and collector base junction is not allowed to raise above the base by more than 0.4 volts and so on. Okay. Otherwise what will happen is the collector based junction becomes forward biased, and the PNP transistor enters into a saturation mode of operation. Okay. And if we have to summarize the BJT current voltage relationship in the active mode, we know that now we have understood that the collector current IC is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT, IB is equal to IC by beta, which can also be, so substituting for IC, you can also write IB as IS into e power VBE by VT divided by beta, and the emitter current is equal to IC divided by alpha, or it can also be rewritten as IS e power VBE by VT divided by alpha. Okay, and if in case of for a PNP transistor, you need to only replace VBE by VEB. Okay, so your IC will be equal to alpha into IE, or IB is equal to 1 minus alpha into IE, and again you can show a relation between alpha and beta as alpha is equal to beta divided by 1 plus beta, or beta is equal to alpha divided by 1 minus alpha. Okay, where VT is the thermal voltage, and which is also given by KT by Q, which is equal to 25 millivolt at room temperature. Okay, and one more important current component is the collector base reverse current. Okay, that is the ICBO. Okay, and we have actually not shown that in the slide, but this current cannot be ignored. Okay, and the small reverse current that is carried by thermally generated minority carriers. Okay, this ICBO is a very small reverse current carried by the thermally generated minority carriers. These currents can be safely neglected in modern transistors, and the reverse current across the collector base junction deserves some it needs some attention. The current denoted as ICBO is the reverse current flow from the collector to the base with the emitter open circuited, and this current is usually in the nano ampere range, and a value that is many times higher than the theoretically predicted value. And as with the diode reverse current, ICBO contains a substantial leakage component, and it is the values dependent on VCB. ICBO depends strongly on again temperature, approximately doubling for every 10 degree raise in the temperature. Also, it is interesting to note that in active mode of operation of BJT with the corresponding mode of operation in case of a MOSFET, the BJT needs minimum BCE of about 0.3 volt and a MOSFET may need about which is almost equal to say in the case of modern technologies, and it is ranging in the in a value range of 0.2 volts to 0.3 volts. Okay, and so we see a great deal of similarity, and also the reverse biasing of common base or the collector base junction of the BJT corresponds to pinching off of the channel of the MOSFET. And this condition results in the collector current or the drain current of the MOSFET to be independent of the collector voltage or the drain voltage in the MOSFET. And again, the temperature coefficient of ICBO is different from that of the IS because ICBO contains a substantial leakage component. Okay, so this is about the characteristics or the transistor, about the current current values. And here we can see that the transistor characteristics of the of IC and the at different values. Okay, the current and the voltage characteristics and the effect of temperature on the collector current and the voltage VBE. Okay, so at constant, so IC is equal to IS e to the power VBE by VT, and at constant emitter current I, the VBE changes by -2 millivolt per degree centigrade. Okay, so now let's move on to the early effect. Okay, so in case of the early effect depending on the IC. Okay, so the early effect is a variation in the width of the base in the bipolar transistor due to a variation in the applied base to collector voltage. Say for example, greater reverse bias across the collector base junction increases the collector base depletion width, and if VCE increases, VCB also increases. Okay, and that is VBE will be less than, VBE is less than VCE, and which is again less than VCE2. Okay, so if you see here, okay, this is less than this. Okay, so the emitter base junction is unchanged because of the voltage VBE is being same, and the emitter base and also the base narrowing has two consequences that affect the current. One is there is a lesser chance for recombination within the smaller base region, and secondly, the charge gradient increases across the base, and consequently the current of the minority carriers injected across the emitter junction increases. So to countervail the early effect is a lightly doping of the collector region and heavy doping of the emitter region. So the current in the active region depends on VC, and VA is a parameter for the BJT, which can be between 10 volts to 100 volt and is called as the early voltage. Okay, so due to the decrease in effective base width W as the reverse bias increases. So this accounts for the early effect with additional term in the collector current equation. And non-zero slope means the output resistance is not infinite, and IC is the collector current at the boundary of the active region. Okay, In the common emitter, so you see the circuit for the circuit seen here is for a common emitter configuration, okay? Or the conceptual for measuring IC, we see characteristics of characteristics for a BJT. The common emitter configuration is considered, and here the emitter serves as a common terminal between the input and the output terminal is what output port is what we see, right? So the voltage VBE can be set to any desired value, adjusting the DC source connected between the base and the emitter. So at each value of VBE, the corresponding IC, okay, for each value of VBE, the corresponding IC and VCE can be measured point by point by varying the DC source, okay, by varying the DC source connected between the collector and the varying the DC source connected between the collector and the emitter. And this results results in the IC VCE characteristics, and it is also known as the common emitter characteristics. So at low values of VCE, say for example 0.3 volts, the collector voltage goes below that of the base by more than 0.4 volts. The collector base junction becomes forward biased, and the transistor leaves the active mode and enters into the saturation mode. Okay, here it enters the saturation mode, we can also see at this time, however, we wish to examine the characteristic curve in the active mode. But if we observe the characteristics curve through the straight line has an infinite slope, okay, and the extrapolated the characteristic lines mean at the point on negative, okay. So if you see here, the negative VCE, VCE is equal to minus VA, okay. VCE is equal to minus VA, and it is a positive number, and the BJT with a typical value in the range of 10 volt to 100 volt is called as the early voltage. So at a given VBE increases VCE, the reverse bias voltage on the collector base junction, and thus increases the width of the depletion region of this junction. And this is this in turn results in a decrease in the effective base width. Recalling that IS is inversely proportional to W, we see that IS will increase and that IC increases proportionally. And this is called as the early effect. And for obvious reasons, that it is also known as the base width modulation effect. Okay, so this is about the early effect and dependency of IC on the early effect dependency of IC on the collector voltage. And so what is the causes that you see for the early effect is increasing VCB causes depletion region of the common collector base junction to grow, and so the effective base width decreases, and hence it obviously it is called as the base width modulation. And and the second cause is the shorter effective base width, that is higher dn by represent higher dn by dx. So your in can be represented as ae q dn dnp of x by dx, which is also can be written as aeq dn minus np of np by w. So the output resistance R naught is equal to delta ic by delta vce, which is which can also, so delta ic can be delta ic by delta vce can also be represented as va plus vca by ic, which is also equal to VA by IC dash. Okay, so the output resistance is given by VA by IC dash. So this is about the output resistance and the early effect. Okay, so just so let's have a quick quiz time now. This is just to know your understanding. So kindly go through So we have roughly four questions, quick four questions to test your understanding on the past three lectures that we have had. Okay. So the first question is, in idle diode model, diode in the forward bias is considered as a dash, whether it is considered as a resistor, a perfect conductor, or a perfect insulator, or a capacitor. So choose the right answer here. And the second question is, reverse collector saturation current ICBO is dash, that is the collector current when emitter current is zero, or is it the collector current when the base current is zero, or it is same as the reverse saturation current, or it is the collector current when the emitter, when either the emitter or the base current is zero. Okay, choose the correct answer here. Let's see whether your answer matches with the answer. Okay, and the third question is, the voltage drop produced by the diode at forward bias in an ideal diode model is equal to 0.7 volts, or is it equal to 0.3 volts, 1 volt, or 0 volt. And the next question is, BJT is biased to dash, it is work as a switch, or whether it is biased to prevent thermal runaway, or it is biased to increase the DC collector current, or it is to operate in the saturation region. So let's see what your answers are. Okay, so the answer for the first question is that the ideal diode module or a model diode in forward bias is considered as a perfect conductor. And similarly, for the second question, the answer is reverse collector saturation current ICBO is the collector current when the emitter current is zero. Okay. Yeah. So let's see. Check your understanding. We'll end the session three now. And let's see. So the answer for your question three is voltage drop produced by the diode at forward bias in ideal diode module is equal to 0 volts. Okay, and BJT is biased to work as a switch, prevent thermal runaway, increase DC voltage current. Okay. Yeah. So to prevent the thermal runaway. So we'll stop here for the lecture three. We'll continue our discussion of module one in the next section. Thank you, one and all.